Unit 7.
What do you do in your spare time?
A. Sports. Conversation 1. Listen.
What do you do in your spare time?
I'm keen on sport, especially football.
How interesting. How often do you play?
Well, we usually have a match once a week, and we do a fair amount of training during the week.
Are you interested in any other sports?
Yes, in winter I usually spend the weekend skiing, whenever the weather's okay. And what about you? What sports do you like?
To tell you the truth, I'm not much of a sportsman. When I was younger, I used to ride, but I've given it up. Now I enjoy watching matches on television.
Conversation 2. Listen.
What should we do this afternoon?
How about going for a drive in the country?
Well, I don't really feel like it today.
Why don't we play tennis then?
Good idea. Oh, but are the tennis courts open today?
Oh no, how stupid of me. It's the junior championships today.
Shall we go swimming then?
Fine.
Let's meet outside the swimming pool. Let's say at about 4.
No, I'll pick you up at 1:45.
Just to remind you,
England is the home of sport. School and college sports are an important factor of student life. They help to develop the sporting spirit that is often appreciated more than knowledge. They form the character and teach team spirit. That is, cooperation and self-sacrifice for an ideal, and esteem for one's rival. Whether Oxford or Cambridge wins the boat race by a few seconds is really of no importance. All that matters is that the young man is a good sportsman.
English people don't only like sports and games, but they are also fond of watching sports events. After paying for the things he needs, the typical British person spends most of his time and money on watching sport. There are a lot of sports competitions worth watching all round the year. For example, the famous cricket test matches, the Derby, a famous horse race, the Wimbledon tennis championships, and of course, the boat race on the River Thames.
Role play. Listen to this conversation and then act it out with another student.
Hello, Peter. You're looking very fit.
Oh, thanks. Hello, Caroline. Yes, I've just taken up tennis. It's terrific.
Oh, that sounds nice. Where do you play?
I play at the local club, not far from here.
Oh, really? Do you think I might be able to join the club?
Yes, of course. You should, in fact. Have you ever played before?
Well, I used to play at school. Actually, I was quite good at it, only you know how it is. I've given it up since then.
Oh, I see. You sold your tennis racket or lost it or something. Well, you don't even have to buy a tennis racket.
Really?
Yes, you can borrow one from the club.
Well, I'd really like to join, you know. I need to lose a bit of weight. I swim regularly, but I think tennis might be more fun because you're playing with somebody else. When could I join?
Oh, you can join any day, any afternoon between 3 and 5 o'clock. In fact, I'm going there now, so why don't you come with me?
B. Hobbies. Conversation. Listen.
What do you do in your spare time?
I like collecting stamps. It's my hobby. I started it when I was a child.
How much time do you spend on it?
Much more than I should, I'm afraid. And what about you? You travel a great deal. Do you enjoy it?
Oh, yes, I absolutely love travelling.
Some people find it boring.
Well, the interesting thing is that however much I travel, I never get sick of it. I always find it very exciting indeed.
B5.
At the psychiatrist's. Listen to this conversation and fill in the missing words.
How long have you been suffering from these complaints?
8 months.
That means since you retired.
Should I be taking something for it?
No, you don't have to take any medicine. The trouble with you is that you've got too much free time. That's why you feel fed up and bored. Why don't you take up a hobby?
You mean that might cheer me up a bit?
Of course it would. Filling your time with an interesting hobby would stop all your unnecessary worries and would give you a lot of pleasure.
I suppose it would, really.
Well, you say you don't sleep well, so I'd suggest an outdoor hobby, perhaps, so that you get a lot of fresh air and also some physical exercise.
You mean skiing or sailing or something?
Well, I wouldn't say skiing or sailing were the right thing for you, because you can't do either of them all the year round.
Oh. I suppose I could collect stamps or something like that.
You see, the trouble with most collecting hobbies is that you spend most of your time indoors.
Yes, I would really, wouldn't I? What about painting or photography?
Those are good hobbies if you have any talent for them. When you paint a picture or take a photograph, you do something interesting and creative, and you're not even confined to your home. The only thing is, it won't give you a chance of meeting people.
No, it won't. I could go down to the photo club, I suppose.
Oh, I didn't know they'd started a photo club in the village. In that case, photography is the ideal hobby for you. Try to enroll as soon as possible. I hope you will enjoy it and make some new friends. Read and relax.
A letter to the editor. Sport should be fun.
Dear Anne Landers, I am a senior in high school who has always enjoyed participating in athletic events. Three coaches in our school act as if high school sports were a business. If the team doesn't win, they get furious with the players and make us feel as if we have let everyone down. If a person is in sports for a living, I can see why winning might be important, but why should high school competition be so important? I enjoy sports, but I consider it healthy exercise, good competition, and fun. I hate all the unbearable pressure put on the players to win. Please, Anne, tell the athletic directors that many guys like myself have been turned off by their attitude. I have participated in competitions and games outside school, and I had never felt the terrific pressure to win until I played on a high school team. Just sign me A.N.Y. Griper.
Dear Griper, of course you are right, but the coach who turns out winning teams gets support and praise from the community and the press. He also enjoys victory dinners, plaques, and silver cups for the showcase. Often it means a salary increase. It's unfair to put down a losing team that happens to be outclassed. I agree such coaches should be cut to size. A joke.
A football manager died and went to heaven, where he was given charge of a truly immortal 11. The only drawback was that there was no opposition. Then he got a telephone call from the devil.
How about fixing up a game with my team?
Asked old Nick.
By all means, but I think it's only fair to warn you that I have the greatest players of all on my side,
replied the manager.
Perhaps,
agreed old Nick.
But I have all the referees.